Let's give a hand for Shamashit Jackie.
Shabbat shalom, everyone.
Shabbat shalom.
When Rabbi then asked me to share, I thought, no, I'm not a public speaker. Then I thought of my favorite scripture, Joshua 1:9. That talks about being strong. Do not be terrified. Do not be dismayed. For Adonai your God is with you wherever you go. So just how God was with Joshua, he's with us today. So then I felt comfort. I felt comfort to speak. I said, okay, my daughter did her bar mitzvah. She came up here and she did this, so I could do this too. Okay, so in this week's parsha, Ekev, Deuteronomy 7, 12, from all the way to chapter 11, 25, it reminds me of Joshua 1:8, which reads, "This book of the Torah should not depart from your mouth. You are to meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. For then you will make your ways prosperous, and then you will be successful." Joshua was successful when he meditated on God's word day and night. And he went into the land, and they got the land of milk and honey, and he fought his way through, and he got his promised land. In Parsha Ekev, it means, I looked it up, it means if you follow instructions, as a result of following God's guidance, his mitzvah, you will be blessed. So in Deuteronomy chapter 7, 12, Adonai wants to bless us. He wants us to follow his commandments. It's for our own good. So what stood out to me in the parsha is in Deuteronomy 8:3. God wants us to understand that man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of Adonai. Meaning, food and drink is not sufficient for a healthy life. Man also has spiritual needs. So I thought, what are the spiritual needs? How do we feed our spirit? It's something that I was guiding my daughter with. I was like, we need to feed our spirit, because as we feed our spirit, we grow spiritually with God. So I thought, one, reading the word, reading the Torah. When we read the Torah, it brings us life. The word is life. Number two, praying. Praying keeps us connected to God. Last week, I was teaching the children about prayer, and it was amazing how they just love God and how they came up with words like, oh, emotionally connected to God. Well, that's one child. And you remember saying, well, God wants us to pray all the time. And I remember Daniel saying, well, God wants us to follow him in prayer. And all the kids mentioned a different, you know, way of staying connected to God when they're so young, but yet they understand prayer is necessary, and not just when we need to pray, but at all times.